Hello, my name is Elena and today I will present the test and the results we have obtained while profiling warm and live migration features for bhyve. At first, I would like to tell some words about me. I'm a PhD student at the Faculty of Automatic Control and Computer Science from University Polytehnica of Bucharest. I started working on bhyve related projects almost 3 years ago. I was involved in the Save Restore projects and in the migration features for bhyve projects. Currently, I'm a teaching assistant in University Polytechnica of Bucharest, and I work as a mentor with bachelor students on bhyve related projects. Bhyve is the FreeBSD's hypervisor, for which we have implemented warm and live migration features. We want to bring these features into upstream, and we thought that it would be nice to profile the code in order to determine what should be improved. Also, the live migration feature uses a dirty bit to discover the memory modifications and has some changes in the virtual memory subsystem. And we want to be sure that we didn't add some overhead to the code. Bhyve has the following components: a kernel module that interacts with the hardware and with the CPU virtualization extensions, which is VMM, a library libvmm API that translates the state from the user space to the kernel space using IO controls, IO cuttles, and user space tools such as bhyve load, which loads the guest operating system. This may not be used since the user can choose UEFI as a loader. Bhyve run, which runs the virtual machines, and bhyve control, which is used to interact with a running machine. We will also use bhyve control to tell the VM to start the migration procedure. The migration procedure means that we want to move a virtual machine from one host to another. There are three types of migration. The first one, called warm and live. The cold migration means that we need to shut down the VM, copy its disk image and to the destination, and then restart the VM on the destination host. This is by far the most expensive way of migrating a VM. The warm migration is supposed to pause the VM, copy its state to the destination, and then resume the VM activity based on the copied state. It is better than cold migration since you don't have to stop all the services, they are only paused. However, when talking about guests with a lot of memory assigned, gigabytes or even terabytes of RAM, the warm migration procedure may take a lot to finish. The live migration aims to have the smallest downtime. Well, ideally it should be instant, and the guest is supposed to be migrated while it is still running. In our implementation, we have some requirements so that the migration procedure to work. The first requirement is that the host must be in the same network or to be connected in some way, so the state can be transferred via sockets. Also, the guest memory must be wired, well, only for the live migration feature, because we interact with the kernel and the virtual memory subsystem, and we need some pages to be present. For the moment, we do not support live migration for unwired guest. Also, the guest disk image should be shared between the hosts. We don't support or we don't have a feature to migrate the guest disk image as well. Also, it is important that the source and the destination guest should have the same startup setup. Well, we talked about previously about the guest state, because it is the most important part in a migration. What means a guest state? Well, it has three components: the kernel structures, which represents timers and guest CPU state, registers, interrupts, etc. The emulated devices, these are usually implemented in the user space and usually are PCI-related structures such as virtio or things like network and disk. And the third component is the memory. If the first two components state size should be small, the memory can be large, so there should be some special mechanisms in order to migrate to the guest memory. In our implementation, we migrate the two components using the save and restore feature we have implemented for bhyve, and for memory, for live migration, we have some algorithms which implement this transition. So, the save and restore feature for bhyve was recently added to the mainstream. In order to use this feature, one should compile the FreeBSD code with the bhyve snapshot option activated. The save mechanism pauses the VM, saves its state to disk files, and then stops and destroys the VM. The restore part practically gets the guest state from those disk files and recreates the VM. The warm migration feature in bhyve is implemented as a wrapper on the save and restore function. The mechanism sends data through a socket instead of saving data to snapshot data to files. The downtime for warm migration is basically all the time when a guest is migrated. The live migration uses the same connection API as warm migration, but it has some differences related to the memory migration. Remember that the live migration means that the guest is running while the VM is migrated. So, while the VM runs on the source host, an empty VM is created on the destination host that waits to be set up, so it can replace the VM that runs on the source host. Well, in order to do that, we should migrate to the guest memory. So we do that in rounds. In the first round, we migrate all the guest memory from source to the destination. In the second round, only the pages that were modified since they were last copied, and so on. In the last round, we stop the VM, copy all the remaining pages and the guest state, including the remaining guest state, CPU, timers, emulated devices state, and so on, and send them to the destination one where the guest is resumed. Before presenting the test, I would like to present a comparison between warm and live migration features to bhyve. Even though the two migration feature uses the same snapshot feature to migrate kernel structs and emulated devices state, the main differences are related to the memory. While the warm migration uses the memory retrieved from base address field from virtual machine context, so basically from the user space, the live migration uses a mechanism that has a dirty bit in the virtual pages, so and it copies, and based on that it determines what pages are were modified between rounds, and these pages are extracted from kernel space. So we copy the pages from the kernel space to the user space, we send them to the destination, and then copy them from the user space to the kernel space in the destination on the destination side. For testing, we modify the bhyve code such that we measure the time for each migration round, and also the downtime. This for live migration, and the downtime for warm migration. We have three test cases that we run. Well, three test cases for live migration and one test case for warm migration. Since it doesn't really matter what we are running during warm migration, because the VM is paused during the migration procedure, it doesn't really matter what it is running. So the first test case is the simple one of the simple way of testing. We start the VM, and then the user does nothing, only the operating system does its internal procedures, and we migrate to the VM. We do not interact in any way with the VM, we just let it run. Okay, and second test is supposed not to be intensive, but to test all the components such as network, disk, and timers. We start the VM, and then we run a script. This script is basically a while to loop, which tests the timers using sleep and date, the network using pings, and the disk using touch and list. Then, in order to be sure that the operating system does not report any issues, we run a DMSG to see if there are any messages. The first test case is the one that runs stress test, a memory stress test. We basically want to allocate as much memory as we can and modify it in a while through loop. This means that in each memory round, almost all the guest memory should be migrated. When testing, we had the following environment. We have one gigabit per second network and three hosts. Two of them are used as a source and a destination host, and the third is used as an NFS server, which is a way of sharing the guest image between source and destination. As a testing procedure, we start a VM on the source host and run one of the tests. Then we start an empty VM on the destination, and we add the minus capital R option to bhyve along with source host IP and the port, which means that this VM will listen to connection from the source host, so will be prepared for migration. And the first step is to send the migrate option to a running machine on the source host. For that we use bhyve control with --- migrate option for war migration and --- migrate live option for war migration. Of course, we set up the destination host IP and the port for migration. Okay, as for results for war migration, for testing, we run the test for guests with assigned memory from 1 gigabyte of RAM to 9 gigabytes of RAM. For the war migration, we can see that the downtime increases in a linear way, which is expected. Okay. In this case, the only bottleneck should be the network. These are the results for the first test for live migration. With blue, we can see the first round where we can send all the guest memory. It is comparable with the war migration. And with orange, even if it's not very visible on this graphic, it's representing the downtime. As we can see in this case, the downtime is extremely small. So this shows the intended behavior of live migration. For the second test, we wanted to be sure that the devices worked correctly, so that sleep ends, that date shows the correct date and time, that packages are sent to the destination, and that touch modifies the correct metadata so that the disk works. Okay, for the memory stress test test case scenario, we allocated as much memory as we could. So for 9 gigabytes of RAM, we could allocate it at most 8 gigabytes of RAM. That memory is written permanently, is modified permanently. As we can see, with blue is represented the first round where all the memory is migrated, and with orange the downtime. As you can see, all the other rounds sent over the network almost all the guest memory, including the downtime, which is pretty big, almost comparable with war migration. As I said, the in each round almost all the guest memory is sent to the destination, which means that the network is flooded with unnecessary data that will be overridden in the next round. As a comparison, we compared warm and live migration. With green is represented the warm migration feature, the downtime for the warm migration feature, and with red the downtime for the live migration feature. With blue is represented the downtime for the live migration feature in the best test case scenario. As we can see, in all the tests, the downtime for live migration is smaller than the downtime for war migration. In the case of the network, we saw both for warm and live migration, the communication used all the bandwidth, almost all the bandwidth, the available bandwidth. Which may or may not be a good thing, because on one hand we may think that it means that the migration will end sooner, but on the other hand it may affect other nodes on the same network, because it uses all the network. Maybe we should add an option for the migration, such as KVM does, to set up the maximum bandwidth that should be used. I don't know. Also, we want to test the migration on 10 gigabits per second network. This is still work in progress. This will the test will be run in the Faculty of Automatic Control and Computer Science cluster. We have the nodes, and we need to get time to set up them and run the test. As a conclusion, we can see that there are some improvements that should be made for the live migration, such as some of the rounds may not be needed, as you could see in the worst case scenario each round send the same memory again and again, and maybe we should detect this and reduce the number of rounds. And also we should see if we want that the migration to a feature to occupy the entire network, or we want to limit it. The warm and live migration features can be found on the GitHub, FreeBSD UPB, and we plan to rebase the code and open reviews on Fabricator so that the community can give us feedback and so that we can bring the projects into upstream. Thank you for your attention, and I wait your question.